Hello world, and welcome back to IMAGATFDS, which is I Made a Game About the Flash devlog series. In this episode, I will show you how I made the second level for the game, as well as the main menu. So let's jump right into it. Have you ever thought, wouldn't it be cool to see the fastest man alive go up against the fastest animal alive? Yeah, me too. So I made a pixel cheetah in Photoshop, gave him a nice little run animation, and here's how it looks. Oh, and if you're wondering, yeah, I drew the cacti myself. Epic! The idea I had for this level was that the race would occur in different parts of the world, or in different environments. Some of you may have seen a similar idea implemented in the Tom and Jerry movie. So I made a forest background along with the already existing desert background. I also added a neat little countdown. After a bit of thinking, I decided that the straight alignment of the backgrounds would look better. Before we proceed, I'd like to introduce a segment called Poems for Programmers. Coding isn't hard for us who copy and paste. No programmer has a card, as it would be a complete waste. We sit at home, typing away all our worries, wondering whether in this dome we will achieve any of our glories. Some say that Python is the best. Others run quickly to C# defense. Honestly, it's not a debate for a horde, because in the end, it's Ctrl+V that's gonna be clicked on the board. It seems like my creativity is growing faster than e^x. Anywho, moving on. While I was casually talking to my brother about the level, he gave me a great idea, which was to add hurdles, and therefore I implemented that. Well, kinda. Instead of hurdles, I kept books, because it seemed kind of ironic that you had to avoid the book. Take that, English teachers. One of the best abilities of the Flash is phasing, whereby he vibrates his molecules so fast that he can just go through stuff. So I added that ability into the game by just turning the player's collider off when the phase button is pressed, and then turning it back on by adding a trigger after each obstacle. If you didn't understand, then no need to worry, because I will show you how it works soon. Here is how I made the phase button and implemented it in the game. Here is the trigger that I was talking about earlier, which will turn the player's collider back on. In this clip, you can see that when the phase button is pressed, right now, that the collider turns off. And when he goes in front of the book, the collider is back on. And the same happens again. Button is pressed, collider is off. Passes through the book, collider is back on. Nice. Speaking of nice, my channel just hit 57 subscribers. I promised a slap reveal at 50, and so here it is. Go subscribe, or else I will do to you what I did to him. Also, at 70 subs, I will do an atom reveal. Yeah, I'm not kidding. Anywho, let's proceed. I recycled my enemy spawner from the first level and modified it a bit to become an obstacle spawner. And it works. Awesome. To finish up, I made the pause menu and the winning and losing screens. For the losing screen, I just added some text with some buttons for restarting, exiting, and going back to the main menu. While for the winning screen, I added a key obtaining mechanism. I did so by integrating my code with a cool key obtaining animation that I made. Lastly, I followed a tutorial by Brackies on making a main menu, and with the help of my friend, whose channel's link is in the description, I made a main menu for the game. And here's how it looks. The video in the background was made by my friend, while everything else was crafted by me. I polished up the race by adding some audio and slow-mo, and here is the end product. Unfortunately, I can't win the level, but in my heart, I won. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. If you liked it, then make sure to like it. A part 3 will come out soon, where I make the boss fight. So do stick around for that. So till then, don't make any foes, and adios, amigos.